Clouds! There are so many kinds of clouds, from dragon shape to bunny shape to flower shape. But scientifically, there's a lot of kinds too. This cirrocumulus, cirrus, allostratus, stratus, cumulus, wait, why do all these words sound so similar? Well, science names them based on their shape and how high up in the atmosphere they are. Like cirrus more or less means thin curl in Latin. So clouds with cirrus or cirro in the name are thin and usually pretty high in the sky. Stratus and cumulus are the lowest, and clouds with alto in the name are somewhere in the middle. But the most epic ones are cumulonimbus. These are the tall giants you might see in the sky before a big storm. They can be miles and miles tall. The word nimbus means rain in Latin, and that's just what these guys do. They make it rain. Clouds do a lot more for the planet than just bring some rain. They can trap heat or block out some of the sun's more harmful rays. But science doesn't know a lot about them, like why they rise at the speeds they do. But we do know that they aren't like little fluff balls you can hug on a magic carpet ride. Way to ruin my childhood, science. So what else is up? Stars, and we've got a video explaining how they got there.
They start out as clouds of gas and dust that slowly start to collapse under their own gravity, growing denser and hotter in the process.
Well, there you have it. Go ahead and subscribe for more little science nuggets every day. Thanks for watching.